Good morning all. I am VC from VC's Academy. So today's class we will discuss about root pressure and transport through xylem, one of the important concept in transportation lesson. So this comes as an activity question. So what is our aim? Our aim is to show root pressure in plants. So what are the apparatus required? Potted plant, glass tube, clamp, rubber tube and tub. So what procedure we are going to follow? Potted plant is watered thoroughly. So as shown in the figure, the apparatus is set up like this and the plant is watered thoroughly. A cut is made on the stem of the potted plant 1 cm above the ground level. So we can see here the cut position, the stem is cut. And why we will do the cut and all? The glass tube is connected by means of a strong rubber tube to the cut where it is made. The size of the glass tube should be equal to the size of the stem. Care is taken that the size of the stem and the size of the glass tube are in equal in size so that the further activity can be done. The stem is tightly bound with the tube so that water cannot escape from the tube. So uneven size of the glass tube may result in the leakage or escape of water from the tube. So in order to avoid this type of situation, we will select the glass tube which is the size of the stem and we will fix it with the rubber tubing, and so that it will fix tightly and no escape of water is done from the tube. And water is poured in the glass tube until the water level is seen above the rubber tube and the level of water is marked as M1 in the tube. So the water level is marked as M1. Where M1 is marked? M1 is marked above the level of the rubber tube in the glass top. The whole experiment is undisturbed for 2 to 3 hours. On an average, it is for 2 to 3 hours. And therefore, the water level in the tube is marked as M2. So, our main experiment is to see that there is transport through xylem. So what our observations will be: water level increases from M1 to M2. Initially when we kept the apparatus for 2 to 3 hours, before 2 to 3 hours it was marked as M1 and then now it came as M2, and the interference will be pressure in the xylem vessels made the movement of water from root hair to xylem vessels through root cells. So our inference will be, after the experiment and observations from M1 to M2, is that the xylem vessels made the movement of water from root hair to xylem vessels through root cells. So here root hairs plays a major role in carrying the water from the surroundings to the xylem vessels so that it has increased from M1 to M2. And the pressure forces the water upwards. The pressure which is exerted in the root cells and in the cells makes a column of pressure, and this total pressure is called as or known as root pressure. I hope all understood the concept, and we will see the next concept in the next class.